Welcome back to the MQTT Essential series. In this part of the series, we will talk about the main features and the characteristics of MQTT, and we will see why it's such a powerful protocol for everything related to the Internet of Things. First of all, MQTT is an Internet of Things messaging protocol. It is built upon TCP/IP, it has minimal overhead, it's simple, and it's designed for reliable communication over unreliable channels. And if you think about it, many Internet of Things scenarios have bad connectivity where you have, for example, Wi-Fi or a mobile network, where communication is sometimes pretty hard and you have a lot of interruptions. So it could be, for example, if you're building a car, that if you drive through tunnels, that your user and your device will lose connectivity frequently. And MQTT is really built for these kind of scenarios. And it's super simple to implement, it's super simple to use, and it uses the best technologies the internet is also built upon, like TCP/IP. So when we look at the characteristics of MQTT, we have multiple characteristics which make it really, really useful for IoT. Number one, it's binary. Binary is extremely important because the Internet of Humans is built upon text, HTML, for example, and HTTP. These are text-based protocols. Very good for humans, but for a machine, text-based protocols are not as suitable. Binary protocols like MQTT are built for machines and are super efficient. Which brings me to the second characteristic, it's efficient. It was built around maximum efficiency, so the smallest MQTT packet actually has 2 bytes. So it's really, really efficient on the wire. It's bi-directional, so as soon as you have a connection from your device to the cloud, you can send data from device to cloud, but you can also send data back from cloud to device. The fourth part of the characteristics is it's data agnostic. Data agnosticity means the protocol does not care what you're sending over it. You can send like XML files, JSON files. You can send your own custom data format you need for your application. Or you can just use things like Google Protocol buffers. And even users are using this for sending pictures or sometimes even video fragments over MQTT. And the fifth characteristic is it's really, really scalable. So here at HiveMQ, we have customers who connect more than 10 million devices over the same installation. It's built upon push communication, which means you really have the lowest latency you can have. As soon as a device sends data to the cloud, to the broker, which we'll cover in a later video, this software will push data to all devices who need the data. So there are use cases where we talk about millisecond latency from device to device over the internet, which is really great. And last but not least, MQTT is built for constrained devices, which means if you have not a lot of computing power and you're very restricted with memory, you can still use MQTT. And in fact, there are libraries out there even for an Arduino, but of course, there are also libraries out there for Python, for Java, for C, for C#, and also newer languages like Go and Rust. So this is really great because all of the characteristics make it so suitable for IoT. And as I said, it's built upon TCP. And this is huge. And let us look into this a bit more closely. MQTT requires TCP. And this is great. Most of the internet protocols we have today run on top of TCP. And for MQTT, the usual stack is we have IP, we have TCP, and then MQTT on top of it. MQTT uses persistent TCP connections. So as soon as a connection is established from device to cloud, the connection will be there and will be used here. MQTT has also built in a heartbeat mechanism on top of TCP. So even if a TCP connection breaks for some reason and you have a so-called half open socket problem where either the server or the device doesn't recognize that the TCP connection isn't available anymore, MQTT has a detection mechanism called heartbeat, but we will cover this in detail. And what is really great is you can use TLS, which is the security transport layer, on top of MQTT. So you can use TCP, TLS, and then MQTT. So you also get an encrypted connection. You can reuse all the state-of-the-art libraries like OpenSSL together with MQTT. And people are wondering, why do we require TCP? And it's pretty simple. Because TCP already guarantees a lot of things MQTT builds upon, and so it can be super efficient on the wire. MQTT builds upon TCP because TCP guarantees that packets over the internet are transferred, reliable, ordered, and error-checked. And MQTT leverages this fact. And so it's super efficient and super tiny. So now we have talked about the characteristics, and now it's time in the next video to talk about how MQTT actually works, what is this publish subscribe everybody's talking about, and how you can apply this to you. So stay tuned. Also, don't forget to subscribe below. We will release one video each week. So we have the MQTT Monday. So each Monday you get a fresh video into your inbox. So don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video.